Alright guys, so Fulu coming to you with another video. Shout out to the whole LDBC. If you like this video, feel free to subscribe to the channel and also like the video and just stay tuned for what we have. You know, I had to make a decision about going to that Charlo and Harrison fight, but it looks like I'm going to take this lump and not cover this fight due to the simple fact that the guy I'm going to talk about is fighting next month, and you know, where he's fighting is more, it's kind of like more desirable, and it's a good thing to do for like a little vacay, you know, just to like chill out, fall back. But I want to talk about the whole situation in regards to this, because some interesting developments have came out, but I don't know how true those developments are, but it appears that Eddie Hearn has offered Jermall Charlo a one fight deal in order to unify with Demetrius Boo Boo Andrade. And I don't know how true this is. I really don't know how credible this is. I mean, for me, I really, because I mean, with Eddie Hearn, you just never know. I mean, you know, Eddie Hearn plays all types of games. You feel me? So you just never know if he's like really like truthful or not. But it appears that, you know, he wants to do a one fight deal with Jermall Charlo in next year to fight Demetrius Boo Boo Andrade. If this is true, this just shows that Boo Boo does not duck. Okay? And if it was the case that he would duck, then I'm pretty sure he would have tried to find a way to halt this from happening. But it's obvious that he's willing to get in there and dance with Charlo. So, like, this notion that he's ducking and stuff like that, I don't know where this comes from. I really don't know where this comes from. You know, and the way Charlo was talking, saying that he's chinny, he's a southpaw, then try to test his chin then, bro. Let's see if you can test it now, because now the ball is in your court. If you're going to, like, if it's true, all right? I really don't know if it's true, but the article said that, you know, that he's been trying to make fights for him and trying to get big fights for him, but nobody wants to dance. I don't know if that's true in regards to Eddie Hearn, because it's really hard for me to trust anything that dude says. But whatever the case may be, if he offers a one fight deal, that just shows that leverage is being shown. And with that one fight deal, it's like Jermall Charlo will still be advised by Al Haymon. So it doesn't mean that, like, that he'll leave the Al Haymon camp. It doesn't mean that. It just means that, you know, in order to get, like, a really, really competitive fight, you know, he's doing that. He's going that route, you know, and it's only one time, you know, that he has to do it. So if he's doing it one time, then it shouldn't be a problem for him. And I don't see anything that would get in the way of this fight from happening, you know. Because at the end of the day, as I've said in previous videos, they don't really have much of an option unless they just want to fight these Mandos that nobody's ever heard of. And that's just the reality of the situation, you know. So, you know, I just would think that, you know, he would consider that and consider taking a shot at trying to get two belts, you know, trying to unify the division. Because, I mean, Canelo vacated the 175 belt. So that means I don't think he wants any parts of the 175 guys. The guys that are up at 175. I think he's honestly really going to contend at 160. I really do. Well, I don't know what his plans are, bro. I really don't. But two belts, if the person has two belts, that makes it more desirable for him to want to fight that person. Basically, if they have two belts. You know? So, in the meantime, though, and I'm not gonna lie, it's not the best stay busy fight, but nonetheless, you have to choose the lesser of two evils. Either stay inactive and get ring rust, or stay active by fighting whoever's available to fight and whoever's willing to fight. Okay? That's just how it works. That's just how it has to be. Okay? And, you know, the guy he's fighting, Luke Keeler, I mean, it's not the best opponent. Don't get me wrong. I mean, I think he's like 17-2. And he has 5 knockouts. No, that's not the best opponent, okay? But it's the available opponent. Morata wasn't available. And the other guy, Steven Butler, who decided he wants to fight Morata instead of Andrade, was not available. And, you know, seeing that this fight is on Super Bowl weekend and it's going to be in Miami, Florida, this is where I kind of want to put my focus towards, and so I'm gonna just like go to this fight, and that's how we're gonna do that, you know. And I'll cover that fight, you know. Now, granted, it is the zone, so it's not gonna, I don't think it's gonna be as lit as a PBC thing, but I'm going for my countryman for one, and number two, you know, Miami has some good energy that I really actually miss over there. And so, you know, I want to get that energy back. You know, I want to be able to experience that energy that I had when I was there before, you know. So that's what it really comes down to. You feel me? And you know, we just, I still believe that, you know, Bubu Andrade, that the floodgates will open sooner or later, you know. Sooner or later, the floodgates will open. You know, it's only a matter of time. But anyhow, that's just a little bit of news. Again, Eddie Hearn appears to have be preparing an offer for Jermall Charlo, one fight deal at the zone. I don't know if it's credible, but if it is credible, then there's no reason why the fight can't happen then. And it shows that Boo Boo is willing to fight him too. Unlike some of these people who say that he's ducking him and, you know, saying that he's the boogeyman of the division. I'm talking about Jermall Charlo. And I'm just going to be real, and people are going to be kind of upset at this and get on me, but Charlo's boxing is very basic. What Charlo has that makes him dangerous is explosiveness. He has explosiveness and the power and athleticism. He has three high qualities, but skill-wise, he's basic. you know. And that's not an insult. That's just how it is, you know what I mean? When you have, like, when in boxing, like, for example, like, when you have one area that is better than the other, you try to maximize that area. But I like fighters who actually work on different things. You know, I like fighters who actually, like, every fight, they're bringing a different look to the fight. You know, they're bringing something else. They're bringing some new tricks, you know, that they've been working on in the gym. You know what I mean? But anyhow, man, that's all I got for now. Leave your thoughts and leave your comments about this, these current developments, and let me know what y'all think. Fula signing out. Jarama.